Hello, I'm Justin with Liquid Web. Firewall D is an excellent tool to use to manage your network traffic rules. It's actually a wrapper for IP tables, and its implementation is meant to make working with firewall rules simpler. In this video, we will take a look at how to stop and disable Firewall D on a CentOS 7 server. One huge caveat here is that leaving your server without a firewall in place is not a recommended practice. In light of this fact, it's important that no matter what your reason is for stopping and disabling Firewall D, that you have another solution in place before or immediately after stopping the service. With that very important note out of the way, let's get started. It's worth mentioning that during this video, I'm logged into my CentOS 7 server as the root user, and you'll want to be as well. Let's start by taking a look at the current status of Firewall D. To do this, run the command systemctl status firewall d. You should see an output similar to this, and as you can see at this time, Firewall D is both running and enabled. In order to disable Firewall D, which will prevent it from running at boot, you can run the command systemctl disable firewall d. You can then check the status again to verify it is in fact disabled by running the same status command I mentioned earlier, systemctl status firewall d. You should now see disabled on this loaded line after the path to the firewall d service file. You may also notice that the service is still running. To stop the currently running firewall d process, you can run the command systemctl stop firewall d. When you run the systemctl status firewall d command again, you should see on the active line in the status output, it is now inactive or dead. That's all there is to it. You now know how to stop and disable Firewall D on CentOS 7.